at the beginning of every basketball season.
347 teams all have the same dream.
To make the NCAA tournament.
And possibly win a national championship.
This year for us,
that dream became a reality.
Although we came up a game short of the Final Four.
We proved that Kansas State is on the rise.
Every dynasty has a beginning.
And this is ours.
This is our journey.
From Selection Sunday
until the final buzzer.
This is K-State Confidential.
Everyone, I'm Greg Gumbel. Welcome to our New York studios and the NCAA Basketball Championship Selection Show. And this is the West region, the number one seed in the West, the Orange of Syracuse. Now, Thursday and Saturday games in Oklahoma City. The number two seed in the West, the Wildcats of Kansas State. You guys are dancing.
Everything has just changed in Manhattan so far. You know what I'm saying? We're not looked at. Has the same old basketball players. You know? We're kind of looked at as celebrities now.
For the people on the committee to put us in as a two seed is extremely rewarding for these kids.
When you talk to the younger generations, the students that have graduated here in the last 15 to 20 years, all their memories are football. So it's tradition-rich school, but it's one that has slipped a little bit in basketball.
Once I got here, just starting to see how many Final Fours, Sweet 16s, Elite Eights, conference championships, it was just astonishing to me that a program that had so much success and so much history could have been separated from that for so long.
It's crazy, like how this school was a football school and then turn around and be a basketball school now. Right now, everybody be talking about us because how we play. How we are.
You figure out the best game you feel we've played, we've got to play better than that every single time we line up in this tournament. Because every team in the tournament knows that the next time they lose, their season's over, their career's over. So everybody plays better than they've played before because of that fear. Okay? If you keep your focus in, man, as a basketball team, the way we have for the majority of the season, you don't allow for distractions. You don't get wrapped up in silly stuff, and you continue to keep yourself committed to this basketball team, especially with the focus and the attention that we had this past week, good things gonna happen to this team. I know it will.
I just wanna tell y'all, man, no matter what happens, y'all my brothers, and I love y'all to death. I love y'all with all my heart.
Love you too,
y'all.
Love you too, love.
We can do this!
This is Wildcat Insider, again, Wyatt Thompson and Brian Smoller alongside. This is a mature basketball team, but in any respect, is there a concern that K-State could get too amped up at a certain point in time?
I think so. I think the second round would be the concern that would come to mind. Really, the biggest concern right now for K-State, I think, is just we're blocking up the peripheral stuff and getting concentrated solely on basketball.
We're probably one of the only teams that live year-round, man. That's why I think we got to be so physical. We live year round, not daily. Now that we go by, when we take a week off from lifting. We got one of the craziest strength and conditioning coaches ever.
Yeah, you don't get one of these.
That's good achievements right there. Like,
you gotta be a beast to get one.
Ah, that's nice.
I got like 7-8 of them in my career.
Hold up, Lottie.
What up, Scott? Tournament time, CK. It is tournament time. Run to the Final Four.
Gotta go, Cal.
Hey, that's great. You're big and strong in June, but we're not playing any games in June. I want you to be the strongest. I want us to be working the hardest going into the tournament.
I think when it comes down to it, you know, those games that you got to grind one out, you know, I think that gives us the edge because we've been through it. You know, we had a 45-minute lift before a three-hour practice. So, you know, that type of stuff makes us better, I think.
Commit yourself to doing whatever is asked of you to go win the next game. Then if you win the next game, then we get to practice.
If you're late and you don't push up, you got one at the end of the practice. Drive through and don't get open. That's what we just finished working on.
He's so intense on the court, screaming at you, throwing the ball, sweating, and being all angry. But at the same time, he has the biggest heart I've ever seen on a coach.
He's not the coach that walks into the huddle and you're down 30 and says, great job, guys, everything's gonna be okay. He's the coach that walks in the huddle and he's a realist.
Some people don't like that, to hear the truth, and they're gonna hear it from Frank, and our players grow to accept that and like that, and I think that's one of the tremendous attributes of Frank.
I sometimes get those looks when I'm in the stadium or, you know, when he gets a technical or something, they give me that look like, oh my God, I can't imagine what your life is like at home. But I mean, Frank is completely different with me. He's loving, and some would probably say I'm the mean one.
I'm not very good at hiding my emotions, but once those 40 minutes are over, it's all about people. It's about being able to coexist in this world with the people that you're around every day. It's about your family. It's about those kids that parents have trusted in me to continue the education of those children and make them from young men to grown men.
Every time he speaks and every time he talks, you get a lesson out of it. He teaches something. To me, he's been one of the greatest because he pushed me to a place where no one else could and no one else has accomplished, and he did it.
That's pretty good there.
And I told you now, at the end of the day, man, don't ever, ever allow the season to come to an end and you go back and say, man, I wish I'd only tried a little harder. Let's go get six. Why not?
I gotta understand that this is my last year, so after this year, I'm gonna turn pro, and it's something gonna be different, it's gonna be something about my own, but when I'm in college, I wanna be special.
He left Puerto Rico to try and utilize basketball, to give himself a chance, not only to play the sport that he loved, but to make a better life.
His senior year. You know what I'm saying? And if I was a senior, I would feel the same way. I would not want to lose any game.
Someone tell you you got one shot to do something, you know, and it's something that you really want to do, you're probably going to go as hard as you possibly can.
That 160-pound guy, I would take with me to fight anybody just because of his will to succeed and his will to win.
It's about Kansas State team, not about one dude. I think God gave me that bless to be a leader. And be the point guard to be, make everybody happy around me.
People are just excited to get there, man. Whether it's bus ride, plane, tricycle, bicycle, whatever, like, we're just excited to get there. The Big 12 just gave us some video cameras. So I'm gonna be documenting this this NCAA tournament trip too, so it's gonna be fun.
Ready to go?
Yeah.
Hey, this team's not really complicated at all. Say they score on cross screen, down screen, that play's coming again. And again, and again, and again. They'll run it over and over and over again until you prove you can stop it, okay? Let's watch these guys. What do most teams do when we've played them this year that want to try to alleviate pressure? Go to the high post. If they pitch it back to this guy, so what? He's not going to shoot from the 10-second line. Once they break down out of their set, it's just a high-low look. They just go high-low with interchange, okay? Okay.
We got like weeks to prepare for certain teams, and this time we only got a couple days, and we right into the war with them, into the battle.
I felt like we were as ready as we were going to ever be, you know, and I just knew that, you know, we had experience.
We try to create a level of competitiveness.
One possession. That's Mississippi State, 41 on the clock.
We understand that the games are hard, that the games are a little more physical.
Point one, they'd be in the tournament. They would be in the NCAA tournament. Point one, good rebound, bad shot.
And really tried to define our execution on both ends.
Whoa, 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 whoa. So why do you catch the ball, throw it right back to Clemente facing the wall? Get him out.
We were prepared, we were ready to go, and that's what you aspire to have as a coach, is that at that time of the year, should be a well-oiled machine.
That's it.
Mom, if you see this, I love you. Hi, Mom. I love you, Mom.
Rose in the Final Four, starting right now.
Come on, man.
Oh.
Get ready to go to Oklahoma City, try to take care of Texas.
Yo, we in the middle of Kansas right now. You see, check over there. That's haystacks right there, yo.
The type of stuff you don't see, you know.
They never show you this type of stuff when they recruit you.
When I get bored, I have to find something to do. I was tired after practice, so, you know, I got my rest, and I wanted to make sure that everybody knew I was woken.
I seen this movie, like, twice. I don't remember it.
But you want me to tell you what else gonna happen?
Eating unhealthy, Scott probably wouldn't like this, but Scott ain't on the bus.
Josh, what's up? Josh, you sleep?
I said it, I'll say it again. You just have to not listen to him. If you listen to him, he goes away.
You ain't listening to me, huh? Do you listen to Peaches and Cream?
He tries to start things. He tries to get a fight going. He tries to, I'm saying, divide the room. But it's funny.
Sit with you.
Sit with me.
Yeah.
Yo, there's not a lot of room in these seats, my brother.
We'll make room. That's Brad, B-Rad.
Jake, just remember, we control playing time.
Jacob is full of charisma, full of personality, and yet as a player, he's a very dedicated, very do-it type guy. He keeps everybody in the right perspective, and nobody's safe from Jake.
Hey, Rod, matter of fact, call my girl for me. Okay. Tell her I miss her.
We call her what?
Yeah, call her your
phone. It's imperative that you comprehend this.
The next time that we assume that there's a tomorrow, there's not going to be one. The next time you assume, hey, I'll do better at next practice, ain't gonna be there. You guys comprehend that? And I ain't trying to throw pressure on you. I'm just trying to be honest with you. So you don't feel sorry for what we can't get done because we weren't prepared. Team, 1, 2, 3.
Team. Get up, get up, get up, get up. Jason, go get it. Get up, Rod. Get up, Rod.
Oh.
Nobody steps in the high post. They let me.
Go, Lou. Air ball. Go get it. Go get it. Go get it. Get up, Tank. Get up. Quick, Tank. Come on, J.O., you gotta run! So help me, the good Lord willing, if you get hung up on this screen tomorrow night, or today, or any time, I may knock your teeth out.
If you don't like anybody yelling at you, you would not like Brad at all.
J.O.!
Throw it, Doc! Throw it! Crap!
Stop! Look where you went to!
Brad brings a lot of energy. He's the man, and he's an older guy, he's an old school guy, and he brings it.
Brad will come in the room and let a bombshell go, and that gets us so energetic and hyped and just try to beat the snot out the next scene.
He wore the uniform here. He understood that passion better than any of us when we got here. When guys aren't willing to do some of the things that they need to do to succeed, he understands when the time is right to let them know that some things are not acceptable.
Honest to God, as athletic as you guys are, I don't see how they should ever catch.
It's not only yelling, but it's trying to motivate. It's trying to find out what that day needs.
There's already a guy here.
It's something that it's my personality. I don't run from that. It's the spirit I have in me to drive guys to become their best.
He's playing him well.
His intensity and his attitude towards the game make you want to go hard and make you want to have a passion for the game and energy towards the game.
For him, it's more personal than people can think of.
Good, nothing, hold it, ball screen, ball screen.
When you lived in Kansas, you played for Kansas State, and you saw the good times. You can't live with yourself going through the bad times, so he's eager to get us back to where K-State belongs.
What's up, man?
Got a tape.
It's game day. Everybody's relaxing right now. It's trying to not think about the game, but wait till we get to the locker room. But I'm saying it's a big game for us, and we know that, and can't let our fans down.
I don't know, it's exciting. I've never seen the NCAA court live. You know, when you're a little kid watching the games, you're just like, you know, wowed by all the players, but now it's time for us to take care of our own business. So it's definitely exciting.
Well, for
Pete's sakes, that's quite the elevator.
Hey, this is exciting. Good luck today.
Thank you.
Knock him out. Hit a home run. Let's go to work, man. Let's go to the next level.
Already.
You guys are beautiful, man.
Thank you, man.
You want to see a team out there
playing for their life, man. It's gonna be a big time game, big time atmosphere. I'm excited. So we'll see what happens. Just gotta leave it on the floor. Whatever happens, leave it on the floor.
He's my brothers and I love them, man. And I'm just so appreciative of them, cause without them, I wouldn't be doing this. That we all put the work in together, and now we together in such a great situation.
Rely on your experiences of the season. There's a reason we played the third hardest schedule in the country, to prepare this team for this moment. I told you guys, it's our time. It starts today. Come on. Three, one, two, three.
Team. For the Gators with BYU in our first game of the tournament. And the Gators go up by two.
And back and forth we go.
We were ready to go. We had seen some upsets already happening. You know, we just wanted to get our tournament experience underway.
Looks like they're going to try to get it to Jimmer Fredette. Good if it goes. In overtime.
Well, we're waiting a little bit longer now.
Tournament time, March Madness. Don't get no better than that.
I was like, come on, I don't want to go to third overtime. I'm trying to get this over with and then move on so we can play these guys.
Oh, money out.
Switch on defense. Now Macklin is watching Fredette with a three. Bulls! What a shot by Fredette!
It was kind of actually a blessing in disguise, you know, because after the first overtime, we were real antsy. People standing up, waiting. But second overtime, people started to relax, and we were able to just be patient and let the game come to us.
Have beaten the 10th-seeded Florida Gators 99-92. Now they'll take on the winner of 2nd-seeded Kansas State and 15th-seeded North Texas. And away we go.
In the first couple minutes, I was just so tired. I just ran out of breath. I don't know if I was trying too hard, but I just wanted to get one more point on the opponent, and I wasn't even looking to score.
And Shorter drives inside and punch back up and in by Trammell.
The Mean Green like to push when they get the opportunity.
They lead by one.
It wasn't a very strong opponent, but you never know. You know what I mean? You never know what team may come in and just want it more.
Good looking rebound inside by Curtis Kelly. Here is Clemente over Williams. Nice shot by Denny Clemente, who averages 16 points a game. Flying the other way, Cole. They can't keep up with his speed.
No, he can really go, can he?
Clemente into Mander, off to Sutton. The Wildcats in high gear now. A 14-3 run by Kansas State.
It's about advancing, man. It's about figuring out a way to win the game. You got to understand. They're in their locker room, and they got seniors and upperclassmen that understand that their season also comes to an end. So they're not going to go up there and jog around like it's a game in early December. Let's figure out a way to get this win so then we can talk about our next game after this game.
And we're underway here in Oklahoma City. Here's Kelly, the UConn transfer. Curtis Kelly wheels inside.
I owe it to my coaches and my family who put me in this position. K-State helped me get the love of basketball again, because I lost it when I was at UConn a little bit. But I gained it back.
Life's not about not failing. Life is about how you react and how do you handle failure. I'm not saying his time at UConn was a failure, but it wasn't as successful as he wanted it to be.
It's Kelly. That's some of the dominance of Curtis Kelly with a nice feed on the wing.
He felt like he had sold himself short when he was at UConn. He felt he didn't give it his all, and, you know, Frank was able to give him that opportunity.
Wow, and a sweet rejection inside by Kelly. Here is Sutton. The other way! Up high! And down hard! Kelly, he has been flexing his muscles in the second half. He's got 15.
It's tough to grow up being something and then going to somewhere and you become nothing. And then you try to build yourself back up to something. And that's what I think K-State helped me do. I'm just blessed to be here, be a part of something that was so great.
In the NCAA tournament 2007, they're back now.
Russell puts in a three from outside. K-State wins by 20. And Kansas State officially advances, and that will be a beauty on Saturday with one of the most unique players in all of college basketball in Jimmer Fredette.
One down, CBS, bro. Never been to Salt Lake City, man.
Lo mismo otra vez, ¿eh?
Oh, this is my other boy, though.
Thought I'd let you know.
As soon as we transition from the North Texas game, that game's over, the press conference is over, we're on the bus, we get to the hotel. It is now BYU.
All right, a couple of things about this team. Average 84 points a game. They are a tremendous transition team. So, Kurt, all your chest beaten after you score a bucket, they're going to shoot a three at the other end. This is a very, very hard-running team.
Before we left for the tournament, we had BYU cut up. It was edited. We'd been through it. We had 6, 7, 8, 9 games broke down.
Fredette, probably the hottest player in the country. In their conference tournament, he averaged 37.5 points a game. Tonight, he had 37. It's change of pace, it's crossovers, and it's getting to the foul line.
When you have a quick turnaround, but you got to know what they're doing, you got to understand it, you got to do a good job of studying it.
He shoots more underhanded shots than you can imagine. He gets to the line a lot. He wants you to foul him.
He always went right to left crossover. I wanted to focus in on that when the game started, when I got a chance to match up with him.
They are going to shot fake you to death. If you leave your feet, you have committed a foul. Does that make sense? If you leave your feet, you have committed a foul because they are going to jump into your body so they can get to the free throw. When you're shooting 84% as a team from the free throw line, you do anything you can to get there.
You don't get much sleep. You're grinding, you're watching film, and you're preparing. That's what makes it great for coaches. That's why we love it, because it's what we do.
Hey, after watching more tape last night, what I want to do is when they ball screen with their five, I want to trap them. Listen, Fredette's going to get shots, man. He's a good player. What we don't need is him getting shots and everyone else getting threes, too. That gets people in trouble.
You got to get right there. Don't go up that way.
Rodney, come off the screen. Get to the baseline.
How many more mistakes you want to make in one play?
Don't let them shoot threes. Don't put your hands on them. Don't foul. That's the key to the game right there.
I'm tired as hell of watching tape, but there's nothing I'd rather do tomorrow to watch more tape. Let's get this done tonight. Team, 1, 2, 3.
Team.
All right, Kurt, we'll see you, man.
Snow. Snow, man. I don't like it.
Don't let the situation change who you are. We need to play our kind of basketball. We need to be aggressive. We need to attack. We got to post. We got to throw it inside. We got to rebound the ball. We got to get out there and run. We got to take the shots we've taken. Unbelievable trust in you guys, man. I told you yesterday, it's our time, man. It's our time. Go get this.
No, I ain't studying for my midterm, man. So I can't go back to school. Man. We gotta go to Salt Lake City, man.
We gotta start by winning today, though. No letdowns, man. Attack! 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 Play hard. 1, 2, 3, play hard! Be crazy, man.
Point four. They do. On the first day of spring, number one has fallen.
Isn't this something?
It's BYU and Kansas State, and we are underway. That shot gets it back to Fredette. He is averaging 37 points a game over the last three games he's played. Jackson Emery puts it in from outside.
I think I was just nervous. I was about to throw up on myself. I was so nervous. I was like, wow, like, this can't happen right here.
Screen by Miles, and that's a three, and it's put in by Jackson Emery.
That was tough. I mean, I looked up and seen 10-0, and Frank called that timeout. I was thinking to myself, like, man, if we don't start now, it could get ugly quick.
That's when I just thought to myself, like, yo, what you want to do, Kurt? You want to call quits in this game and try to do something to get out the game, or you want to be a man and try to keep playing?
I called play for him, and then I see him make one. Okay, shoot the next one.
Jacob Pullen for the triple.
That is a great offensive sequence.
Okay, shoot the third one then.
Pullen for three. His third three-point hit. He's got nine.
No doubt at all.
You know, Jake kept telling everybody, he said, man, I got a test to take on Thursday. We can't lose this game. You know, we got to be playing in Salt Lake City.
I'm just going to say this to you. You guys have earned the right to play next weekend because of everything you've done all year. You've got 20 minutes to play, and you got a 10-point lead against a team that you just turned the 10-point deficit into a 10-point lead because you settled down and you stuck to the things we talked about doing. Continue to do this as a team.
Let's go up 20, man, to separate this game, man, so we can rest. We got to start out on fire, though. We got to come out playing like we down 10, man. Play hard. One, two, three,
play hard. Let's go, on the glass, bitch.
Pullen for three. Hawes with the close. Another three. He has been an assassin today for the Wildcats. Clemente for three. And he's in double figures.
Boy, that's a big basket.
So knocking it away is defense again. Pullen. To the rack.
Just when BYU needs a basket, Pullen creates that steal.
Suffocating defense on Fredette.
The one thing that Jacob does and did all year long was took the challenge of guarding the other team's best player. And he loved that challenge.
He just can't get around Pullen.
With that speed, who can?
Jimmer was literally fatigued, very tired, worn out. And that's a tribute to Jake and his competitive drive.
When you go back into the history and you look at the last time they made it to a Sweet 16 or Elite Eight or the second round, I mean, it's been years. It's been years.
Pulling Sutton, there it is.
It's something that K-State hadn't accomplished, something that we had wanted to accomplish, and we finally got over the hump. So, you know, it was a reason to celebrate that night.
They are going to travel to Salt Lake City and the Sweet 16. For the first time since 1988.
Hey, big bro, man, CBS can't tell me what I can't do, man. We here, man. We here.
Goosebumps. Just goosebumps riding down my body, you know. It's like my first time ever being in a big situation like this in the national stage and going to the Sweet 16, just traveling to different cities. It was amazing, though.
I was like, whoa, this is further than I ever made it, because I wanted to go somewhere else, you know? And I felt like I was on top of the world, like, yeah, we got a chance.
We get to practice another day, baby.
Yes, sir.
There's nothing better in this business than to see jubilation in your players' faces. We live for that. That means all the work you've done, all the screaming that I did, everything has paid off. And for that moment, it is tremendous, tremendous feeling.
Round three.
The first few minutes I took it in and I was excited. But then after a while, I started to calm down, you know, notice that, okay, we come on, Curtis. It's Sweet 16, you did some history. We can keep going.
Hey, you know, I'm watching them grow up in my eyes, CBS. I'm watching these dudes, man. We on the journey, and I seen them take their first steps, man. I'm just proud, man.
Salt Lake City, here we come. But y'all stay tuned, though, for real. Back to Manhattan. I'm going to see y'all there.
Wrong with the Sweet 16, but, you know, back here we still have obligations. Our teachers aren't letting up on us just because we're in the Sweet 16 now. I have a project due at 5 p.m. today. My teammates, they're upstairs in study hall. We still got to do everything that the regular students have to do.
We call him Father Time. You know, that's the guy that keeps us together. That's the guy that's like the father figure in our whole team atmosphere.
He sets the bar high. He works extremely hard in the classroom. And when he works hard, it makes us work hard.
I always tell younger guys, use basketball, don't let it use you. You know, just being in a position where I'm able to use a little bit of the publicity to help other people.
Yep. Everything that I could possibly dream that I would want to happen, happened this year. And he just could never say enough of how much it meant to him.
Yesterday, it was funny, I told my fiance before anybody even let me know, you know, I got an email saying that I was going to be speaking at a pep rally. And this before anybody let me know, so I guess there's a pep rally today.
I'm like 6'5", so I'm all right, you know. Yay!
We're gonna see a lot of those.
No, the free seat. Free seat. Phone?
Yeah, once again, on behalf of all of us at Sun Country Airlines, especially as crew members on board this afternoon, we better be taking you to Indianapolis, Indiana, in a few days to the Final Four. Congratulations and good luck in the Sweet 16. Thanks for flying, Sun Country.
Let's just do it for the guys. I get myself every once in a while too, but we can't be looking. We can't be looking, you know, rough on CBS or during a game when they zoom in during a free throw. We can't be, you know,
stay sharp,
roughing it. There we go.
I'll see you at the game. Okay.
Knowing that the NCAA tournament is gonna be over in a little bit, we just have to make sure that Frank's prepared. So, you know, it does get a little lonely, but when you're winning, it doesn't matter what it takes, we're gonna do it.
Understand something, man. Understand something. The work to win is done. Now it's just the belief in winning. That's all that matters at this time of year. Let's cut these nets down on Saturday.
We pick each other up on the floor for every charge, every loose ball, and we're gonna let somebody who don't want it, who don't play hard, come take what we need. Yeah. Play hard, man. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, play hard.
From the West Regional, here at Salt Lake, our final game of the evening, a 6-2.
Not one time did I say, oh man, that's the team. Man, we blew them out in December. We understood it was a totally different team.
Calling this Kansas State team the Doberman Pinchers. When they smell fear, they attack. Pulling the head down. Pulling, running the baseline, looking for it, fires, and it's everything easy right now. Here come the Musketeers, Crawford, left hand flip, woohoo, with English.
When you see how well they were playing at the end of the year, coupled with their talent level, made it for a lot of sleepless nights leading into that game.
Crawford down the lane, the teardrop, got it. 26-19. Kansas State has led by as many as 15, but Xavier finding their rhythm. Deep jump shot, Holloway, and there is it.
What's the problem with playing the game the way that we started? What's the problem with playing the game the way that's helped us win? What's wrong with playing that way?
Stupid to start the game the right way. Passing the ball, attacking, defending, getting in the open floor, rebounding the basketball. No, but that's too easy. That's doing things the right way. Don't do it right, do it wrong. You cannot play that way at this time of the year. That is silly. Selfish and silly. Do it right. Come on.
This is not the time to feel sorry. This is not the time to get in a foul mood. We got 20 minutes in our season. If we figure out a way to score one more basket than them, we'll get to play another day.
Clemente using that feline quickness. Down the lane, a finger on his jaw. Man, this kid is fun to watch.
We're not too much of a vocal leader, but he a leader by when we need that bucket, he's going to give it to us. Or when we need something to happen, he's going to make it happen.
Clemente, here comes Cologne. Oh, oh, he splits it. The floater, got it.
Oh, man.
That's a point guard.
There's a direct correlation with the way our guys have played as a whole the last 2 years and him being the one wearing the uniform.
61-60. Bullet. Stop and start. Clemente again! Oh, man! And one! Possibly a four-point play! Crawford again! Oh! Another big-time J! And Xavier up by one. Bullen stops. Seven lets it go! And buries it!
If anybody would ask me, yeah, I thought it was game. I'm thinking, that's the dagger. Well, let's walk out of here.
9.7 seconds remaining, 72-69, Kansas State.
3-point lead, under 10 seconds. Make him dribble the ball up the court, foul him across half court, send him to the free throw line.
Here comes Holloway.
I grind him with two hands and then call foul. And when he gonna start shooting the ball, that's when Creed hit him.
Here comes Holloway with the screen. Oh, he's fouled!
I'm like, no, this is not happening. This is not happening.
And he's gonna shoot three!
You gotta be kidding me. You have to be kidding me.
Why didn't they call it on Diddy? It was Diddy's foul.
There's the first foul, and now they didn't call that one. The second foul should have never occurred.
All 4 years, pretty much my basketball career, all culminating up to this one point, and I had fouled him.
And he's the last guy, if you're Kansas State, that you want at the line.
Yo, miss one of these for me, you know what I'm saying, so we can go home and everything will be all right.
First one good.
Come on, Holloway, I said you got miss one for me, Holloway.
Second free throw. Good.
I don't know, I was like, man, throw us a bone.
For the tie. And he got it. We're tied at 72.
If for some reason they lost the game, that he was going to take that personally, and I did not want that to be his last memory of basketball.
So we head to overtime. Holloway three. Oh, bam! Inside, Samuel. 87-84, 11 to go, Holloway kicks it out, Crawford eight.
I was thinking that he's gonna go, like, try to make a move and get closer to the line, but.
Crawford's gotta hurry!
When I seen it release out his hand, I just looked the other way. Cause it just felt like one of those moments that he was gonna make it.
He's gotta hurry! Up! Oh, no! He tied it!
He shot it from half court, like, there's nothing I could do about that, you know?
My mind, real quickly, I said, I don't know if our guys can overcome this one.
What a game it's been. Double overtime. The winner advancing to the Elite Eight. Pull it quickly into the front court, down the lane. The runner, down! Crawford to the basket. Pays it in. Makes it in.
This is one of the greatest games in NCAA tournament history. As it's unfolding, let's win it. Let's win it.
Xavier up by two. Clemente. Now pull it. Turns. Fires. Got it. 50.8 to go. Who's in shape? 19 to shoot. Pull it straight away.
bam! He's in shape. That's it. Kansas State heads to the Elite Eight with a double overtime win over Xavier.
I just thought about, you know, how that locker room would have been if it would have been the other way. And then just like, you know, I started to get kind of emotional.
Hey, I love y'all, man. I'll tell you, I wouldn't have been able to lay that down for the rest of my life, dog. I promise, man.
We're living out of that.
I promise, man. I wouldn't have been able to lay that down for the rest of my life, man.
That was real. And seeing Chris thanking his teammates and excited and crying and happy, all of that, that's what Kansas State basketball is about.
Thank you. I love y'all. Thank you, man.
We play on Saturday. There's only 8 teams left playing in the country out of 347. Now, we didn't play any good today. I'm not going to harp on that. I told you, this time of year, it's about finding a way to get a win. But in your minds, you got to visualize yourself. When that buzzer sounds on Saturday, climbing up that ladder and cutting down that net. That's what you got to visualize in your mind. Because if you can see that, then you'll do whatever it takes to win the game on Saturday. Let's go.
Big time. Yeah. One more, man.
Team, 1, 2, 3.
Team.
We've got to play better than we did last night to beat these guys, okay?
Mac, best player.
We cannot let this guy get going. They jump out to a big lead last night, and it is all because of Mac.
Got to make his life miserable now.
When you start watching them on tape and you start just seeing the way that they play, you understand that you can get knocked off. And in our preparation, that's the first thing that jumped out at me.
That's why every single one of you play, is to get the opportunity to go do what you're doing tomorrow.
Just heading out right now. I'm about to head to the game. They got the blend. Playing downstairs, getting ready for it. Got the, Elite Eight game. You know, first time back there in 22 years. It's time to do work, you know. Leaving it all on the floor right here.
I'm feeling good, man. I want to cut down that net so bad. It's my dream, man.
I kept seeing just us cutting down nets, me hugging my mom, you know. Just really celebrating it. I just saw it all, you know. Everybody was telling each other how they was gonna wear their hats, where they was gonna put the pieces of the net at.
All the way from Kansas, 13 and a half hours. We better make it to the Final Four, baby. We're gonna do it, though.
All right, see you all.
You never know when opportunities come across in your life, but when you earn the right, then you're prepared for when they come across. When you go in and you spend the time that you guys have spent sacrificing for one another, sticking together through the good and the bad, you do it for one purpose, man. You do it to do special things. Go do tonight what you guys have done all year.
That's all it is, man. It's about who wanted the most, man. They want to go home and we don't want to go home.
Let's go.
Let's go take it, man. Play hard. 1, 2, 3, play hard.
And welcome back, West Regional Final, Butler and Kansas State.
Watch for signs of fatigue from K-State after that double overtime classic versus Xavier.
When they ran out of the tunnel, they looked so tired. I was like, oh man, this is gonna be a hard game.
It was the swarming defense of Butler that really dug a hole for Syracuse.
Clemente way short. Norrie with the rebound, Butler with numbers, 3-on-2. Hayward to the rack. Bam!
Like the cell phone that wasn't fully charged going into the game, and we were running out of bars.
Low post, backs his way in and out, and a foul. Sutton gets his own rebound. Rolling, and line it up. Back, looks inside, nicely done. 15-8, Bulldogs.
We couldn't defend like we usually do, and people were out of position, and they were making shots that we knew they were gonna take. We just couldn't get there.
Hayward, and look at Butler, offensive rebounding.
We were a step slow on everything we did. It's the only time all year where Denny and Jake were just non-existent.
Clemente, been hobbled by either an ankle or a thigh. Pulling to the basket. Left hand, no, batted out. Kansas State misfiring again.
It was times where I wanted to just get after it and get some shots up and really just try to just take over the game, but I didn't want to do it so early.
Bullock back. He's got Norred. Jump stop. Count it. And that's it. Maybe the worst half of basketball of the season for Kansas State.
Gotta play, man. Gotta play. Stop making excuses. Why? Why come to play here today to make excuses? Every time Hayward's drove the ball, we've clubbed them. They ain't called it. I don't see him bitching and whining. I see him hooping. Play!
I told him, I said, listen, I've got no problem whatsoever with the way our team has battled all year. We've gotten to this point. Let's go out and play the way we've played all year.
Clemente, 1 of 6 in the first half. 2 points. Bullock, 0 for 2, no points. Right now, Kansas State is looking for leadership. Come on, Bull!
I learned that you gotta be tough. He wanna win any game. You gotta play for 40 minutes, no matter what.
Clemente straight away. Bam! But Kansas State is on an 8-0 run. Hayward, got it. Kansas State doing a lot of crying. The winner of this to advance to the Final Four in the front court. Can Bullock get an easy one? He has a field goal.
We were able to come back, and then at that point I said, okay, we've been here before. Let's go ahead and let's take care of business now. I still felt, I always felt like we had a chance.
18 to shoot, Paul Ampure. Bullock with some bounce in his legs there. 2-point game. For a trip to the Final Four, folks. Sutton with a rebound. In the corner, Clemente with a lay. No! Kansas State up by a penny.
We took a lead. We forced him into a bad shot. In that quick time frame, I thought, okay, we're going to be okay.
Clemente, baseline, up, kill him! What a teardrop! Controlled it.
You know, I really felt like I should have tried to take over the game in the first half instead of waiting to the second half. I tried too late, and I was tired.
And DJ, way up.
It's like having some change on the couch, and you reach it for as far as you can, but you just can't get it. You know, you just can't get that quarter under the couch.
Rejected, loose, saved by Matt.
They gave up on it. Kansas State gave up on it.
To shoot, Hayward,
high up in it. This one just like playing football on a rainy day and the ball just slip out your hand.
Clemente, strip, great play. Beasley, and a play keep away. Butler, 18 seconds away. Pulling, and another steal.
Up until that point, I always thought we had a chance. Until that buzzer sound and they started to celebrate and jumped on each other and everything, and that's when I knew it was over.
That's it! Butler! Going back to Indiana!
It's always going to run through my mind for the rest of my life. We could have made it further, you know? This play or that play could have got us to the Final Four.
I was ready to get a ring for the first time and you know, be a Final Four team, that's a dream.
You can't play in those games unless you invest a lot, unless you're willing to take a chance to be special. And our guys did that. And the chance that you take when you invest to be special is that if you don't make it, it's gonna hurt. It's gonna hurt because you put so much into it.
Proud of our fight, man. But then what gets us every time, the immaturity of this team is two things. Guys don't listen, guys are casual. That's what gets us every time. We take the lead, we can't protect the lead. Now, with all that said, I'm not going to take away the ride that you guys have given me this year either. because you guys have sacrificed. Have sacrificed, have committed yourselves to making us one of the better teams in the country. You guys have re-energized the passion of K-State people all over this country. You guys have given people something to live for again. Winning and losing games hurt, man. But when your message is a lot deeper than winning, losing a game, when you get people following you, believing in you, the way you guys have as a team, that's when you got the makings of something special. So now the decision you got to make is, what's it going to be? You going to work a little harder, fight a little more, so those people continue to believe in you, or are you going to give them a false sense of reality? That's a decision that you underclassmen got to make.
And I can just recall opening up the door and just seeing a wall of K-State fans. Posters, balloons, pictures, flashing cameras going, kids jumping up and down.
I teared up before I actually got to him, and I was just so thankful that the people came out and showed them the love that they showed them, because they deserve it.
They made my night. They made my night, and they made me feel good before I went to bed.
To walk off that plane and walk into that terminal and see the excitement and so many people there, I know it made me wake up a little prouder that next morning.
The city really opened up their arms to us, their hearts to us. I would never thought in a million years that there was ever a place like this.
It just shows how hard we work to get people to fall back in love with K-State basketball. That's all it's about, having the town behind it.
K-State proud. Thank you.